This tutorial will show how to create filters in Gmail. What FirstClass called mail rules, Gmail calls filters. Filters allow you to instruct Gmail on what to do automatically when certain emails come into your inbox so that you don't have to. To access filters, come up to the top right-hand corner and click on the gear. And from the drop-down menu, click on Settings. In Settings, then click on the Filters tab. Here is where you can manage your filters, delete old filters or filters that are no longer valid, as well as create a new filter from scratch. You can also create a filter based on email that's already in your inbox. Since we're going to have our mail migrated into Gmail from our FirstClass accounts, I'm going to try this approach. So I'm going to come back to my inbox and come down to this email that I get from a listserv. I want to filter this email and future emails that come from the listserv. So I'm going to select the email by checking off this box, then come up to the More button and say that I want to filter messages like these. This pop-up window then shows up, and Gmail wants to know, what is the search criteria for the emails you want to filter? How does it find the right ones to filter and ignore the ones you don't want filtered? You can fill in as much or as little of this information as you want in order to make the filter accurate. You can use from information, to information, based on the subject line. Does the email contain certain words or doesn't have certain words? Or emails that have an attachment even. For my purposes, I'm going to use the from field only. Now that I've determined my search criteria, I'm going to come over here and click Create Filter with this search. Now I get to tell Gmail, what do I want it to do automatically when it finds emails that match my search criteria? You can tell it to skip the inbox and archive it, mark it as read, star it, or all three. You can also have it apply a label automatically, forward it, delete it, stop it from being marked as spam. This comes in handy if you have a parent email that Gmail keeps flagging as spam. You can tell Gmail, stop doing that. You can program it in canned responses. And if you use the important labels, you can turn those on or off. For my purposes, I'm going to say skip my inbox, but also apply a label to it. I'm going to use this drop-down menu. I can pick a label that I've already created, or I could make a new label right from this window. In this case, I already have one called Actum. Before I hit Create Filter, notice that Gmail has discovered that there are 6 emails already in my inbox that match the search criteria. And if I want, I can have Gmail apply this filter to those emails that already exist. I think I'm going to do that, so I'm going to check off that box, and I'm going to hit Create Filter. And then now if I go to that Actum label, you'll notice there are 6 emails that have been filtered according to the criteria I set. So filters are a great way to get Gmail to do some email management automatically so that you don't have to do it manually. This concludes this tutorial.